Hey guys, haven't made a washer video in a few months, I think, so let's do one today. We still got the three washers here. We got the 2017 Speed Queen, the 1978 Maytag, and over there is the 1968 Kenmore, which is not being used at the moment. It's got a little bit of rust issues that I need to repair before I go back and use it. I've used it maybe twice for a couple of small loads just in the last year, so it's been sitting waiting for me to get to it, and I probably won't be able to get to it until this coming summer. But it still works, everything's still good, still hooked up. It's just that until I get the chance to get that rust sealed up and protected, I don't want to keep doing anything that would damage it further. So what we've got for loads today is, this one is just a load of colors. There's jeans and some t-shirts and stuff in that one. This one has a couple of sweatshirts, a bathroom little like throw rug, and a big bath towel. And so let's see, I've already got detergent in there. We are using the All Original Stain Lifter, 2x concentrated. And so let's see, this one we're going to run. First off, I'm going to run it as warm and a regular load, and we're going to go extra large. And let's set this around a 10. And this load here, let's see, warm, large, heavy. That looks like what we want. So I'm going to probably be holding the camera throughout this video so that we can get some shots of both machines as things happen. But we will start that one filling and start this one. See the water coming in there. There you go, you can see it a little better. Been kind of busy over the winter, haven't had a chance to make too many videos. I did have the cold start video the other day, and I was out and about after work the day that we had a big snowstorm of wet, sticky snow, and got that short that I made about a marshmallow world, because I just saw it and I thought, hey, I gotta like take a video of that, and we'll see, you know, what, how it comes out. And it came out good enough to make a short with, I think. So take a while filling here. I still only have one dryer hooked up. Pipe goes up behind that one, but it's the Speed Queen that is connected. I still haven't had an electrician come in to wire me an outlet for the second dryer. I need to look into that soon. But usually by the time I get out of work and get home, it's kind of late in the day, and I don't think of it. By the time I think of it, everybody's closed. So one of these days, I will get on it. Now, of course, on the weekend, they're all closed, so. When I got two or even three machines filling, it takes quite a while. Which one will start first? I only started them a few seconds apart from each other, so it shouldn't make too much difference. Starting to see water. About halfway there. This one, I'm still not seeing any water pooling up in the bottom yet, so that one's got a way to go. I suspect the speed clean is going to start first. It's starting to come up now a little bit. Kind of hard to see in there, but I'm seeing water. This one's coming along. It's getting close. Got about two more rolls of holes to go. This one is getting there, but still has probably 3.5-4 inches to go. Like I said, the speed clean started first. figured it would. It's going a lot faster, huh? Check if it's going. Washing a bunch of jeans as they almost turn black in the water. And so it's kind of hard to see stuff, but I got a few things in there that are bright colors, so you'll see them when they come by. An orange t-shirt right there about 10 o'clock. I've noticed I've got the exact same amount of detergent in both machines, but the Speed Queen definitely suds the church amount a lot more than the Maytag does. It's like no subs at all in the Maytag. It's quite a bit speed clean. Thank you. that is just about to stop. We'll have a pause for a minute before it starts to spin. So. Oops, it's just stopped, so that one's got a minute now before it's going to start to spin. Start picking up speed on the spin once the water gets out of there. obviously we're just refilling on cold, so it's going to take longer to fill up than it did the first time. Not using any fabric softener this time, just letting it go regular. I've got some bounce sheets I'm going to put in the dryer when I dry this stuff. Water's starting to come up down the bottom there, slowly. This one, of course, had a good head start at full water pressure for a little while. You can almost see me reflecting down in the bottom. Somewhere. Can I wave? Hi. You ever see my videos and wonder if my machines look a little bit pink? It's because the light up here over the top is a fluorescent, like aquarium light, or like a glow light. I bought it to start some flowers for my flower beds at my old house, like in the middle of the winter one time, and just basically didn't really have any place warm enough to get the plants to do anything, so it didn't do much, and I just had the shop light with those tubes in it, and so decided to use it. I used it at my old house over the Maytag once I got the Speed Queen in, and I set the Maytag up in that other location. I had that same light over the top of it, and then over the Kenmore I've got a LED shop light up there, which definitely changes the color, and plus you get the weird banding. One of these days I'm going to get a new camera that I can shoot at either 60 frames per second or 120 frames per second or something, so that it will do away with that banding. The shutter speed on the camera has to be the same, either like 60 or 120, be in sync with the flickering of the light in order to get that banding to go away. Oh, we're coming along over here. This one's getting close. Couple rolls of hose holes left to go. I can get in there. So there we go. Less than two rolls of hose. Rows of holes left. This one's going to take off on filling as soon as this one, the speed thing, is done. about to, oh, yep, just shut off. That one just cut off. So that'll fill up quickly. Got it set so it stops above that top row of holes. I adjusted the fill level to fill it just slightly more than it used to. It used to come up to like just barely, like halfway up over that hole on the side of the agitator. Now it kind of comes up to the top of it. Out of it, it'll settle down. The weight of the water's been on. So take about a minute for that one starts to spin. it's cruising at full speed. Spin here in just a second. Speed here pretty soon, as soon as it gets some of the water out of the clothes. See, they spin different directions. Camera doesn't want to focus very well. Thank you. stopping momentarily here, just into the last minute. Maytag wins the race, but it seemed like it was lagging behind this one the whole time. And we're done. So, that was a wash in the 1978 Maytag and the 2017 Speed Queen 8 Series. And I guess that'll do it for today. And so, thanks for watching. And stay tuned. We'll see you in the next video, whenever that may be. Take care now. Bye.